60s, we have rights now. Obama's president.
That was another throwback. If you're laughing, you're going straight to hell. And normally, I would say, hey, I do not condone spraying somebody in a wheelchair with a water hose. But when she hopped her ass up out of that wheelchair, I said, you know what? We're going to be able to do this story. Not a problem. She was yelling the N-word to black men across the street. Obviously, it was offensive to them, especially the one who had a water hose. Now, I do not condone violence, but I will submit this. It is a bad idea to yell the N-word to a person who has a water hose in front of you. That's simply not a wise thing to do here, Karen. This individual obviously decided to start spraying her with the water hose. It did create an inconvenience, but at the end of the day, she got wet, maybe, hopefully, learned a lesson. It's not a good idea. Ms. Dahl, thoughts?
I mean, I think you nailed it. The fact is that she, you know, once you say that, once you're going to be so rude and offensive to somebody, I think you're kind of opening yourself up to something. And like you said, it just water, it's pretty harmless. It makes a lot of sense. That's happening, that he had it handy. And I think she will probably think twice about doing that again, especially to him.
All right. Yeah, especially to him. Welcome to Indisputable. I'm your host, Dr. Rashad Richey. We got a lot happening today. But what do we do on this show? We tell the truth. You know why we tell the truth? Because the truth is simply indisputable.
Rashad, great to be here. Congratulations on the new show. And I gotta let everybody know that Rashad and I go way back.
Here's the pattern that we see in all of these Karen stories. They think they own stuff they do not own. Now, where does that come from? I don't know, maybe slavery. Maybe they think they should still own black people.
This is what happens when Karens weaponize the police.
When you're used to privilege, equality seems like oppression.
It hits you in a certain way when someone is holding you against your will, treating you like you're a criminal and you're an innocent person. This is something that black people face no matter where they are.
A stronger black economy lends itself to a stronger, greater economy. Don't think it's exclusive of you, it's inclusive of you.
What's your beef with critical race theory?
It adds more fuel to the fire of the racist tendencies that we already have.
We have a generation of problem solvers that can remedy the problem if they are properly taught what the problem is.
You know who created redlining in this country? The white liberal.
I don't give a damn who created it. If it's a racist policy, Shelly, here's what I don't know. I don't know. See, there you go, filibustering, brother. You're scared of this truth, but you're gonna get it, though.